We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. So working through the week. Tuesday, we've got the coffee morning up at Crabs Cross Salvation Army shop. That's correct, isn't it? In the hub. And things are starting to take hold there. So if you're able, 10:30, 12:30, go up to the Salvation Army hub. Bring all your friends. I can see you're already thinking about it. You'll have a cuppa, a biscuit, and some fellowship. Great time to be had there. Then on Wednesday, 1 till 2, we've got the Powerhouse service. Very similar to this. Gospel service. Everyone is welcome. And we worship God. We go into the Word. We have some prayer, praise, fellowship. And God is really stirring things. Earlier, we counted about 8 churches in partnership and fellowship in the youth service. God is really stirring something new with the partnership and the unity of the body of Christ within Redditch. It's exciting. So what, prayer for Redditch this Tuesday night? Thank you. So Tuesday night as well, 7:30, is that right? In St. Stephen's Church. 7, thank you. You get there 7:30, you'll have missed it all. 7 o'clock. That's it. 7 o'clock, prayer for Redditch again. That's gaining momentum, isn't it, as people are coming together. Also, I forgot to say, so I'm going to rewind slightly. 24 hours of prayer. I've got the flyers with me. John Hardy has already said we're praying for a 24-hour cycle of hour slots. You do it from the comfort of your own home, but you sign in online for a one-hour slot and you dedicate to pray for that hour for Redditch, the churches and everything else in and around and what God is doing.
There's still a few slots free on the Tuesday afternoon.
Yeah, thank you. So do catch me at the end if you're able to bolt an hour and pray specifically. You do it in your own home, you know, so you can brew up or whatever. Sit down and focus in prayer for 1 hour. That lightens the load of all the saints that will be doing it. So then, back to Wednesday. 1 till 2, Powerhouse service. All are welcome. We'd love to see more and more people coming in. Wednesday evening, 6 till 7, Bible study here, adults and youth, do come. And of course, before the Powerhouse service, toddlers, if you've got any youngsters, grandchildren, children, bring them into the toddlers group that is here. They end up with a feast of food because Dawn puts it all up, provides it all, and they receive a spiritual nourishment. They receive the word of God. That is so important in this nation. And I'm going to talk about that later. Then, Thursday, we have the Worship Academy, 6:30 to 8:30 here. We've got the music groups forming. We've got the community choir going to kick back in. We're a rabble, but we meet and we praise and worship God. We've got some carol concerts being formed, so we're only 7 weeks away from actually ministering to the community with those carol concerts. We're going to produce, like we did for the YMCA last year, a carol service with the lessons of the scripture readings, and we're actually going to bless the community with that. I hope. I'll encourage them to bring the earbuds, but we are going to bless them. And so we're going to do that in a number of council locations around Redditch, and that's in negotiation as we speak. Then, Friday, we've got the community luncheon. We're feeding roughly about 20 people a week on average. Do come be part of it. Come with some stomach tablets, because I'm cooking this week. Pray for the people, but we'll have a joyous time. Again, sandwiched in prayer and a gospel message. That is why we do it. But then there's a bit of food and fellowship as well. Then the Recovery Cafe, 2:30 to 4:30 on Friday. And then Saturday. This Saturday, the first Saturday of the month, we're going over to Glory Seekers in Esham. Anyone that wants to connect with that, Will and Tina and all the things that God is doing in Esham and the surrounding area, do let us know. We'll be taking carloads over. Then we move into the following week, being the second week. We have an additional prayer walk on the Wednesday, 3 till 4 around the football ground, so do be part of that. And then evangelism on the Saturday, second Saturday of every month, we go out 10 till 12 and share the word of God. Future announcements, 21st of October, we've got the Salvation Army production, a ticketed event in Birmingham, but if you'd like to come, do let us know, we'll be taking cars over. The ticketed price goes back into the ministry, so it's not money wasted, and it's a great evening of testimony of what God has done in the lives of people in the Salvation Army charity shop. Wouldn't it be great if we could have welcomed them in and expanded the gospel to them? Never mind, God knows. And then the 28th of October, we've got our annual conference, the Youth for Christ annual conference, with the Empowering the Nations conference, 2 till 6pm at Matchborough Church. All are welcome. Let's flood that place. Let's really fill it out, because there's going to be fantastic preaching. I'm not preaching, so do flood it out. You'll be blessed with some international speakers, and God is moving.
Next week.
That is something we shouldn't have mentioned, so you might get a kick as you're going out, who knows? Or Bertie might attack your ankles.
No.
We don't know if you mention such things. But there are a number of birthdays. Dawn's birthday is coming up, as Matthew's just said. Also, Mike's birthday on the 4th of October. We don't let any birthdays be missed. And Helen. Oh, okay, not this time. Lovely.
Oh,
so,
I didn't mean to do that.
Oh, we're celebrating birthdays all this time. It's a birthday season.
Last Thursday just gone.
So we're holding all those people in prayer, and we're going to pray now. Dear Lord, we just pray. We thank you for another year. We thank you for each and every saint that are celebrating at this time. Lord, we pray your blessing upon them. Let them know how cherished and loved they are in this church, in this community, in this body of Christ. And Lord, we just pray your blessings upon them for the future, the next year ahead. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Also, the Good News newspaper is out for October. I'd like to give everyone one or two of these so you can read them, share them, and invite people in to the things of God. Now, Tyson Fury knocking someone out on the back because of prayer in his Bible, apparently. That's an article you want to read. But also, Halloween is coming up at the end of this month. Here is a testimony of a couple of people that dabbled in the wrong things, but then came to a knowledge of Christ. That is a powerful testimony. I do encourage you to read it. I was digging out my bookshelf the other day, not to bore everyone, and I came across a book, From Witchcraft to Christ. And again, such a powerful testimony that I gave it to one of the saints. And if anyone wants to read that, I have two copies. I'm very fortunate in that one. So that is being shared out, and sharing out the things that God has really used, secondary texts. We should be, shouldn't we? We should have bookcases of these things going out, shooting into the hands of new believers. And on that segue, here, I have a book. I'm not selling it, I didn't author it. Amy's Tin Tabernacle. Now, who was Amy? Amy Carmichael. Oh yeah, I saw some faces. Amy Carmichael. I would love to give that to one of our friends from South India in particular, if you've got an interest in it, to read it, to just see how God touched the heart of that missionary who went out from Northern Ireland and seeded the gospel. One of many. Powered by the Holy Spirit and did wonderful things. I recommend that book to you. But, you know, she's a woman that followed the call. So do take that off me if you want. Any of my, first and foremost, any of my South Indian brothers or sisters. But then it can go wider. Share it round, because I think you'll be blessed. You'll know the places. If I say Donavu Fellowship, probably did I pronounce it right?
Donavu.
Oh, there you go. There's a bit of Irish in there. But I think it's an Indian name, isn't it? The Donavu Fellowship. But it's wonderful. And I met a farmer over in Worcester, working alongside one of the trustees for Ready Choose for Christ. And he said, I'm from southern India. And I went, really? I said, Amy Carmichael, and his face lit up. And he went, yeah. And he used some kind of term, southern Indian term. And with such elation. And I went, wasn't she a woman of God? And he said, amen. And we were instantly connected in fellowship. Wonderful book. I do encourage you to read it. But before we move into scripture and worship, a friend has messaged me just before this service, and that's why I mentioned this. She's not Northern Irish, she's Welsh. She's not going to India, but she feels a call to go to Iraq. And she's asked us if we would pray, because at this very time, there are a number of Christians meeting over Zoom and making that decision as to whether she's going to serve in Iraq. So I'd like you to stand if you can. We're going to pray for my friend Lorraine and God's will for her life. And also, David mentioned Paul, Carol's brother. We're going to hold him in prayer. He's not in a good place at the moment physically.
And Gladys.
Yeah, and Gladys. We're going to pray that God will touch Gladys, who has had a fall.
Henrik,
thank you. I did get the message and I've been praying. So Henrik, Gladys, Paul, Lorraine.
Alison from our church, which is her husband's grandfather.
Oh.
Yeah, so Alison and Paul, if that's okay.
Yeah, and I was praying for her earlier, wasn't I, without realising that.
Yeah.
Oh, bless. And Hayley. Hayley, Alison, Paul, Lorraine and Gladys. Let us stand to our feet. We're going to raise those people before God now. Let us pray as God leads.
Father God, we thank you that you are a loving father. A father who watches over his children. And we thank you for the way that you blessed the life of Alison and Grenville.
Yeah.
We thank you that Grenville is now safely home with you. And pray that you will watch over Alison and the rest of the family as they, on the one hand, know and are confident that Grenville is in a far better place, but on the other hand, will, just like all of us, be missing. And Lord, we do pray that as we look ahead, we'll help not just us and our family, but all of us, to walk close with you, Lord Jesus, aware of just how close you are to us.
Amen. And Lord, we pray for these saints at this time. We pray for Henrik. And we pray that you will touch, Lord. Come around him and heal him in Jesus' name. We pray for Hayley. And you know the need, Lord. We pray that you will move, minister and touch. We pray for Gladys. We pray healing for her. And Lord, we pray that you will come around her. Encourage your family to put in the necessary requirements to look after her. And Lord, we pray for Paul. We pray for Carol at this time. But Lord, we pray that at that bedside, Paul will receive your word. He will receive those that will be singing and seeding the things of you into his life. And Lord, we pray that we will take hold and bring him to a saving knowledge of you. We pray for the salvation of his soul. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And Lord, I pray for my friend Lorraine. I pray that she has heard your voice calling, Lord, and if it be your will and your way, I pray that you will just open up everything and just blow down any barriers that would stop her going to Iraq and serving you for the gospel in that place. Lord, we just pray that you will prepare the way, go before her, and if it be your will and way, send her off, use her mightily as a woman of God. We spoke about Amy Carmichael, Lord. Let it be someone that's so fired up of the Holy Spirit that you will use her and use her mightily for kingdom purposes. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And we move into scripture now. A very short psalm, a very familiar psalm that I'm sure we could largely all quote. Psalm 23, and we will read around the assembly. Six verses, so maybe a verse each would allow more to get involved. Let me start. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. Verse 2.
He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. Verse 3.
He restores my soul. He guides me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. If you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows.
Surely your goodness and mercy upon me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Praise God! Many people have sung about it, haven't they? I think Coolio has sung about it, maybe, the rapper. But Keith Green sings a lovely version of The Lord is My Shepherd. And you can Google it, and it's a real powerful, anointed version of such a well-known piece of scripture. But we're going to now move into a time of worship as we hold that and listen to it. You may need to cluster in threes as we move around sheets.
Okay, we're on the sheets. It's sheet with the number at the top left-hand corner, sheet number 19, and it's song number 48, There is Power in the Name of Jesus.
Let us stand and sing.
There is power in the name of Jesus. We believe in his name. We have called on the name of Jesus. We are saved.
Oh, there is no other name that is high.
shall be crushed beneath our feet. For there is no other name that is high in us than Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Call on the name of Jesus. We are saved. We are saved. And His name, the deep tree. And His name, captives are free. Like a sword in our hands, we depend in the name of Jesus. We shall stand, we shall stand at His name. God's enemies shall be crushed beneath our feet.
Chose the cross, if anyone knows the number on the sheet.
51.
Sheet 20, number 51. You chose the cross with every breath, the burden.
Holy Spirit, let your fire
Lord, we may not be the best worship group around, Lord, but our hearts are right towards you, Lord. You're all we need, Lord. You're all we want. Like the song says, this is my desire. Lord, you are our desire. We come here, we gather here tonight, Lord, in the freedom that we have, and it's just to honour your name, Lord. Lord, we pray that you would receive this worship tonight, Lord. As ramshackle as it is, Lord, that you would receive it. as a sweet sense of fragrance, Lord, up to you, as our sacrifice to you tonight, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that we would be living sacrifices for you, Lord, making sure each day we walk circumspectly to your calling, Lord, that we would make sacrifices in our lives, Lord, for you and for what you've done. I heard somebody speak a word yesterday or the day before, Lord, and they talked about sacrifices. And David wanted to give a sacrifice to the Lord, which was the threshing floor. And he had an opportunity to gain this piece of land, Lord. And he was being offered it free of charge, and he said, no way. He said, because I'm giving this as a sacrifice to the Lord, and I cannot give something that didn't cost me anything. And Lord, I pray that we would take that to heart, Lord, that whatever we give the Lord, we know that it cost us something, Lord. It really impacted me, that word. Lord, that we would make sure that we just don't casually come into your presence. But Lord, we give, Lord, things that cost us. Cost our time, Lord. Cost us financially, Lord. It puts us out there. We step out of our comfort zone, Lord, to bring our sacrifices and honour and glory to you, Lord, as we come to the temple, Lord, and lay down our sacrifices in front of you. Because Heavenly Father, you gave your best sacrifice that you could do. You gave your one and only Son, Lord. And how that must have been so painful for you to watch your Son to be whipped and bruised and his beard plucked out, Lord. But you willingly gave your Son, Lord. And Lord Jesus, you willingly took our punishment. You gave your best. You gave your very self, your very life for us, Lord, that we may have eternal life. Lord, I pray that those words would sink into each and every one of us, and we would consider the cost of our lives that we have right now and the eternal life. The cost for us to be able to live for all eternity, that we would consider that cost, Lord. And we would appreciate that, Lord, and not take it for granted, Lord. And know that there's things that we're called to do in this life that will cost us. And we would be prepared to give the best that we can. It will never come close to what you gave us, Lord. But Lord, receive our worship tonight, I pray. Heavenly Father, you receive the honour and glory that you're due. Lord Jesus, our coming King, our Lord and Saviour, receive our worship tonight, Lord, from each one, from the hearts of all the people here tonight, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
37 verses 1 to 14. And as you turn into it, that was wonderful, wasn't it? Wonderful praises of God erupting in this place and God really touching it. I always worry when someone stands up and says, "Are you going to know this one?" And I think, probably not. But praise God, we knew that one. God had worked on us and prepared us for that. Praise God.
What chapter?
Ezekiel chapter 37 verses 1 to 14, and we'll read around the assembly now. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me back and forth among them, and I saw a great many bones on the floor of the valley, bones that were very dry. Verse 3.
He asked me, "Son of man, can these bones live?" I said, "Sovereign Lord, you alone know." And he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones and say to them, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the Sovereign Lord says to these bones. I will make breath enter you, and you will come to life."
I will attach tendons to you and make flesh come upon you and cover you with skin. I will put breath in you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. Verse 7.
So I prophesied and I was commanded, and as I was
prophesying,
there was a noise, a rattling sound, and the bones came together. I looked, and the tendons and flesh appeared. There was no breath in them.
Then he said to me, "Prophesy to the breath. Prophesy, son of man, and say, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe into these slain, that they may live." So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath entered them. They came to life and stood upon their feet, a vast army.
Then he said to me,
"Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, our bones are dried up and our hope is gone, we are cut off. Therefore prophesy and say to them, this is what the Sovereign Lord says, O my people, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from them. I will bring you back to the land of Israel."
Then you will be open your graves and bring you up from them.
your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken, and I have done it because of the Lord.
Praise God, thank you. So, just a few words, just a few thoughts. Victorious in the valleys. Victorious in the valleys. We read Psalm 23, very familiar psalm, which talks about the valley experience. And in Psalm 23, it doesn't say that God's going to prevent the valley experience. It doesn't say that God's going to skirt us round the valley or take us over on a natural bridge. God can do all those things. We don't need to go through the valley experiences. But God, in those valley experiences, states, we will fear no evil, for God is with us. To read it, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. God is with us. God is beside us. God goes before us, preparing the way. God goes alongside us. And God goes even behind us. You know, he cleans up anything that is left in our wake. The before, the present, and the after. God is faithful when we go through those valley experiences. And of course, the valley of dry bones. Some of us can often feel dry bones. Even in the church, we can sometimes think, oh, you know, woe is me. I've had a hard life, a hard week, a hard day, a hard shift. I've seen you working hard. And it can feel, can't it? Oh, you know, the world is on my shoulders. But even in that valley, even in that experience of dryness that we may have as saints, God is waiting to just breathe his air into us. That's right, I've been watching Leap of Faith. Steve Martin, and how he jumps around the stage on the no, I'm getting excited then. He breathes the breath of God into us. And that is the remarkable difference, isn't it? Now, I love my little car. You may have seen it. I've got to watch for those watching remotely. I don't want them to come and take my car. But it's a modest little car, a little one-engine car. It's never going to make the Grand Prix, is it, with all these fast supercars. But that is what we're like as Christians. The Church of God, we're like the 1 litre engine just ticking along modestly. But when the breath of God is infused in us, wow, we're like a supercharged car. It is the breath of God that fires us into all the things that he would have us do. We pray for the rain. They're making their decisions at the moment. That breath of God into that decision as to whether she goes and follows the call to Iraq. If she does and it's God's will, God's breath will go into that and God will use it mightily. We spoke about Amy. What a wonderful woman of God. Just a woman. Breath of God, the Holy Spirit flushing through her and bringing so much life because the gospel was preached, proclaimed and taught and lives were changed. The valley of dry bones, all that has been before, we walk around this nation and the nations and we see those valley of dry bones spiritually. The rain, as I said, is from Wales. When we think back to 1904, I wasn't there, but the Welsh Revival, I promise you I wasn't there. I think you were doing the songs and you were thinking, maybe. And you're good at songs. I'm not that old. 1904, the Welsh Revival, but the dry bones and the carcasses, spiritually, that are in that land. Boy, we were talking about Aberystwyth, Have I pronounced it right? Aberystwyth earlier, and we were talking about Harlech? Harlech, Crickyeth, Porthmadog, Pethelig, all your neck of the woods. And all the things that God has done in the past and sent people fired up all around the nations of this world. The dry bones. But what a look, because we're surrounded by dry bones. Are you thinking of all the dry bones in your community?
No, it reminds me of that song, you know, about the bones, where it's like
the head bones.
Them bones, them bones, them dry bones. That's what it's about, there you go. That's it. Hear the word of God, that's it. So, the dry bones come into life. What I love about this Ezekiel passage though, as they're walking in that valley and they're told to prophesy, they prophesy. And to the eyes, and we spoke about the earthly eyes and the spiritual eyes at the youth service. If you're not coming to three services a Sunday, you're missing out. It's like missing out your breakfast, your lunch or your dinner. You've got to have all three, and then you'll look like me. And a healthy diet with it. But anyway, the Valley of Dry Bones, they prophesy an earthly speaking nothing until they're commanded to do it again. And isn't that a promise for each and every one of us saints? As we prayer walk around this town, these dry bones, and prophesying that God will touch and take hold and convict men, women and children. Even if we've done it once, we're to do it again, we're to do it again, we're to do it again, and know that God will move. God will touch and God will bring new life. New life in the lives of those people out there that are living in darkness. That breath of God that will take them from the old into the new, to paraphrase 2 Corinthians 5:17. If anyone is in Christ, they are a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come. It is that relationship with Christ, that breath of God that touches, transforms, changes, and renews. Praise God. Have you got it in you? Have you got it in you? Breath of God, the Holy Spirit. So even when we're prayer walking, we're commanding God's blessing upon blessing, we're not to stop, because that valley of dry bones will come to life. It's going to happen. I'm so excited every time I think of the valley of dry bones that we've got around us. But I'm reminded, and I'm sorry I'm talking so much about Wales tonight. Janice started it. She made me think of Wales. It's on the heart. The Grace Outpouring. Are you familiar with the book? Yeah. Wonderful book. Roy and Daphne Godwin, isn't it? That just basically went in and did what God had commanded them to do. To pray a blessing upon blessing upon blessing. And I said earlier, they were praying for the roads, safety on the roads, that, you know, people coming and going would be safe on the roads. They weren't praying for supernatural tarmac, but God's safety upon that. They were praying over fields, they were praying over livestock, and God was touching because they were praying God's blessing. That's what we need to do. We need to be praying God's blessing over the kingfisher, which is in a cycle of decline, over the schools that they will hear and preach and proclaim the word of God, because it's almost stripped out of them. Almost. Over the churches, that God will fill those buildings with his Holy Spirit. It'll be so tangible and thick. There's people inquire attentively. They're drawn by the Holy Spirit. They will come under conviction at the very thresholds, proclaiming God as Lord and Saviour. It happened, didn't it, in the 1904 revival and others. God touched. We want it again over these dry bones of this land. And over our communities, our households, our families. We've got dry bones, haven't we? We've got skeletons in the closets. Not literally, I don't want to get the police involved, but skeletons in the closet, spiritually, of family members that need to know Jesus Christ as Lord and Saviour, and neighbours, and communities, and those around us in the town. I praise God, am I allowed to say? I praise God that, of course, a lot of you know, when we just spoke the truth, that with an invitation to Becca, to come into the things of God. She came. God has touched, breathed new life into Becca. And what a shining example of someone who's going to be baptised, professing the Lord, and journeying through that. New shoots. It's so exciting to see. And we want to see more. God is good. God is bountiful. We want to go around this town. I'm sorry, are we? I'm going on too much. We want to go around this town and we want to proclaim Jesus as they have done of old. We want to claim every footfall in the name of Jesus, claiming that ground as God has told us, planting the word of God into the hearts, most importantly, but the hands and into the minds of those that need to receive. We went out on Sunday and did a little bit of evangelism. Sunday today. I'm getting confused. Every day is a God's day. Yeah, special day in God's economy. And we were a small, select little team. Everyone was welcome, but we were a small, selective team. We'd have preferred a couple of hundred out there. But we were out there professing the gospel. And I shared earlier, I encountered two saints that were old and decrepit. I hope they're not watching me on the video. They looked like they looked 30 years ago. They looked very youthful in the earthly state. They looked really healthy, actually. I hadn't seen them for about 20 years, and they literally looked like they hadn't aged. I think they've been sitting in vinegar or something. They were stagnant because although they had a living relationship with Jesus, they professed Jesus, they loved Jesus, they needed that breath of God, even afresh, to fire them up. They weren't part of a church, they weren't part of a worshipping community, yet they are solidly walking with the Lord. I know them very faithfully. But sad to see. Earthly, they looked like they hadn't aged a day. Spiritually, they hadn't matured. They hadn't gone into the things of God and broke through new ceilings, raising that bar for every generation. That is what we should be doing. I mean, I'm not glorifying the lady, I promise you. Amy Carmichael, fired up by God, did remarkable things. We're to raise the bar of Amy Carmichael. We're to see it, we're to say, yeah, it's nice. A few little places of India, set afire with the gospel. I mean, pretty amazing, wasn't it, the way it rippled through. But we should be thinking, we've got the internet. We could do that 10 times over. We could go over, we could pay and support missionaries to go over to Iraq, to other places, and fire up these things as God calls. That should raise the bar. And we should see all the disciples, all those that have come to Christ through that ministry, fired up and doing above and beyond. And we are, to be fair, we're seeing reverse missionaries. And the guy in Worcester, Mark, his name is, he is now setting up a Christian farming fellowship under the guidance of some of our trustees. And he's a man of God. You speak to him, and you can see that God is using him mightily to come back to this land from India, carrying Christ back in order to share the gospel and see it ripple back through this nation. Praise God that we've got people coming back into this land. We need it. These dry bones need to come to life. And we need to prophesy. So victorious in the valleys. God is with us in the valleys. We might feel like dry bones, but we need to ask for that breath of God to re-enter us as the saints, as the church, mobilising and seeing people come in, rooting, discipling them in the things of God, but knowing that as we prayer walk, as we proclaim and bless this town, bless this nation, God will move mightily. We prayed a blessing over the Alex in parts, and that was fantastic. Other saints in the past have prayed a blessing over all the entry points and exit points of the town. We need to do that again. We need to rekindle what God had set in motion. And we need to pray blessing upon every single person we meet. They're God's creation. They're God's children lost through the fall. And we need to draw them back into a loving, living relationship with Jesus Christ and see the Holy Spirit touch their dry bones, fire them up, and rekindle all that He has made them to be. That vast army of God, and we're in such a great place, aren't we, in the Salvation Army? That vast army of God advancing, extending God's kingdom bit by bit by bit, and seeing lives drastically change. Lives change, the new shoots, the testimonies that abound and draw many into a saving knowledge of Jesus. Amen. And do pray for those ladies that just walked past. I missed giving them a gospel message earlier, but they might have caught that little bit. We're going to give out 2 Good News newspapers to every single person that hasn't received them. And we're going to proclaim, we're going to invite, and we're going to bring people in. We're going to pray that the strongholds are ripped down in the name of Jesus. We're going to do more proactive, active evangelism, getting out there and doing it. Are you wanting to be part of it?
Amen.
Well, me and you then. Yeah, praise God, there's 2 of us. But yeah, we want to be part of it. We want to be that mobilisation of the saints that advance on this town. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we pray for all the areas of this town that need a touch of your gospel. And boy, that is every single aspect, Lord. Lord, we pray that you will start with us. We pray that your Holy Spirit will touch us and just strip away anything that isn't of you. Lord, we pray for your holiness to just take hold and draw us ever closer to you in communion. And in that way, Lord, we pray that we will reflect something of your glory into this town, into our communities, and into all those places that we frequent. For me, Lord, the Greggs, the libraries, and the places of this town that you know where I go, Lord, we just pray that you will use me in those avenues. And we pray for each and every brother and sister here tonight, that you will use them in the pockets where you place them to be salt and light for you. Lord, we pray that we may be able to draw many to the saving knowledge of you, through a word in season, through an invitation, and through the praises, the worship, and the word of God going forth and accomplishing all that you have desired for it. We pray this in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Praise God. We're going to move into another time of worship now as I call into the worship team.
If you look at your sheets, it's page number 8 and it's song number 24 at the top of the page, the first song on the page. Jesus shall take the highest honour.
Jesus shall take the highest honour.
You're here.
creation. Now revealed in you our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing but best it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus.
To the 7 p.m. on Tuesday, which is then the crescendo of the prayer for Redditch in St. Stephen's Church. So if you're able to, I'm going to give everyone one of these. If you're able to sign up to an hour slot of prayer, if God is calling you to do that, please do. The important thing to remember is you can do it in your own home. You're coordinating that hour of prayer. You don't need to physically go anywhere to gather. You're not filming yourself, because these were all the questions I was asked. You're not filming yourself praying over the town of Redditch for an hour. You're literally coming into that closet place or place where you can focus prayer for an hour in your home, in your workplace, wherever you can pray. Probably not your workplace for an hour, but depends where you're working. Yeah, don't take that advice. We need our nurses, doctors and professionals that are working hard to keep working hard. But to pray for that hour of focused prayer. Obviously, if you could take a lunch hour in your workplace and do it, that would be something. So I'll also pass these around. We're going to pray for our two sisters in the faith there. So I'd like some of the ladies that will come and minister with me, and the leadership. What's our final song?
It's My Lighthouse, whatever number it is.
Oh, yeah,
on
we'll come round and we'll pray.
I've got a bit of blue ink on the top of the paper.
So leadership, and those that will be praying for the ladies, please.
The song is My Lighthouse. Has anybody found it on the sheets yet?
It's big letters, big letters. One that I gave out.
Oh, right.
One that I gave out. No.
Okay. It's not the numbered sheets. It's an odd sheet in with the sheets.
Big letters.
I rest me in my doubts, in my fingers, all the world counts. Your favor will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubles. Oh, you are the peace in my troubles. Thank you.
Thank you.